Got a minute? This is Sandy from Operation Right Home, and I have a mission I do not want you to turn down. Joann's is having a Craft for a Cause contest. They're asking everybody to submit a project using supplies purchased at Joann's in the name of a charity. And then the person submitting could win up to $1,500 in crafty goodies. How awesome is that? And the organization that gets the most submissions goes into a round of online voting. We're also going to need you to vote if we can get into that round. That round, top prize is $50,000. Imagine how many cards that will ship. Come on, guys, we can do this. We can win this. You just need to make a card and submit it. Now, this video is for crafters and non-crafters. So, first card makers, meet me over at camera 2. I've got a message just for you. All right, crafters, your husbands might not like the idea of you winning $1,500 worth of craft supplies. But just imagine, if you won $1,500 worth of goodies from Joann's, you could buy all the organizational things you need to organize all those supplies you already have. So if your husband gets upset with you for buying more stuff so you can enter this contest, just tell him you're going for the organization. He'll love that. All right, now I've got to go teach these other folks how to make a card. You guys get busy, and I'll see you later. Non-card makers, meet me at camera 1. All right, so you need to make a card for this contest, and you don't know what to start with. I'm going to show you really easy, some super simple things you can purchase at Joann's. This will be under $5. Very inexpensive way to enter this contest and help our heroes have something to write home on. All right? So you need a few things. Joann's does not consider these things you need to purchase, so you need a paper cutter of some sort, and you may have one, or a crafty friend might, or you might have one at the office. You also will need some sort of adhesive. You can use a double stick tape if you've got that in your desk drawer, or a glue stick, that's inexpensive. With the glue stick, I'll be showing you a very special way to use it to make sure that it holds up under pressure when the cards get sent overseas. So when you go to Joann's, you need to purchase a piece of paper. This is 12 by 12, they have racks and racks of it. This one in particular, and the one I want to recommend that you buy, they have a bunch of different colors and different kinds. Two-sided. It's got two sides. It's got a solid color on one side so you can write on it, and on the other side it's got a pattern of some sort. This one I picked stripes. So you need to purchase that. It's only 59 cents. Then you need to purchase an embellishment of some sort. It can be a flower, it can be a sticker with a sentiment on it, it can be, I don't care what it is. They have a ton of choices there. This is a pack of sentiments. These are all Christmas ones, and they were $4 for the whole set, and then I got a 40% off coupon. So, pretty sweet deal. Made my shopping trip really inexpensive. Speaking of shopping trips, save your receipt. You're going to need to scan this in order to send it in for the contest. Do not lose this. Okay? Let's get started and make a card. So, I'm going to first cut my paper. I'm cutting it to 5.5 by 8.5. That's one piece. I'm going to cut the other part into 5.25 by 4. And then I want two of these pieces, so I'm going to cut a second 4. And then I'm also going to take one of these, this long scrap here, and I'm going to make a strip of it that's going to be 1 inch by 5.25 inches. Voila! Paper cutting is done. Get rid of the scraps. Now we're going to take the basic cardstock. This is going to be your card base, and you want to have a bunch of different ways you can do it. You can have the plain part on the inside, plain part on the outside, whichever way you like. But if I'm going to have the fancy part on the inside, I need something to line it. So I'm going to take one of my pieces, and I want that side up, so I'm going to put the glue on this side. And I told you I'm going to show you how to do this. Glue sticks are not my preference because they're messy, but you have to put a lot of the glue stick on. Some people just go whoop down one side and down the other. That does not hold and will not work through the wilds of Afghanistan and Iraq, where these things are going to go into a lot of high temperatures. And then we're just going to line the inside of this card with this piece. Voila! Burnish it down, press it down really, really good so that glue really holds. Now that's the inside of the card. Outside of the card, I'm going to take this strip, and I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to use the other side of my scratch paper so I can make a mess on it, because I want the pattern signed up on this one. You can also do the reverse and change up your design if you wish, but this will be a nice basic card, and we'll have a pattern for the paper on the outside. Just going to line it up. Some people really go crazy and measure it all out, but if you are careful enough, you can get it basically straight, and that is good enough. Okay, burnish that one down really, really well as well. What's this little piece for, you ask? Well, you're going to put glue on it as well. It's going to go across here like this in the contrasting color. So we're going to put glue on the pattern side. We're going to place it. You can place it at the top or bottom. I like to do about 2/3 of the way down. And the fact that I have striped paper, if you are worried about not getting things straight, the striped paper gives me something to line that piece up with. So it has sort of a buckle on it, you might say. And now that buckle is ready for your embellishment. So if we want this to be a meet me under the mistletoe, I can put my sentiment here. I can set it off center, which is kind of what I like to do. There's one last thing you need to do for your card to be an Operation Write Home card, and that is on the back to write Operation Write Home. And you can either write that, or you can write like I did, Made by Sandy for Operation Write Home. A lot of people will stamp it or use a label, but if you're just doing one, you can handwrite it, not a problem. How easy was that? Now you can either purchase just a piece of paper to make one card, or if you think you might be hooked, go buy a stack of paper. That 8.5 by 11 paper, you cut that in half and it makes a perfect size card base. How great is that? Joann's also has these boxes that they have, and this has envelopes and card bases in it. They have all different styles and colors that you can choose from and go crazy on that. And they obviously have tons of stamps and other supplies. Don't get wild, don't go broke on this, but just start by making a simple card for our heroes. Enter it for this contest and see if the card making bug bites you too. All right, everybody go out there and enter one for our heroes. We want to win this for them because they're winning the war for us. Thanks. Bye-bye.